New water restrictions have been imposed in Cape Town, South Africa.
In India, rising temperatures threaten to make a severe water crisis there even worse.
The greatest global risks of our time, the shortage of water.
By 2050, the United Nations says more than 5 billion people could be facing water shortages across the globe.
As our name suggests, the water desalination team is fundamentally focused on removing dissolved salts from water. This process has not yet been perfected, mainly because of the difficulty of working with contaminants on the molecular level. For these reasons, traditional filters just won't do the job. Now, the conventional way of doing this is with reverse osmosis, which has proven to be a successful method. However, this process can be very expensive in most applications. Let us also mention the benefits of what an improved method of purifying water will do for the world. Water is the keystone of life. It's important to everything we as humans do. We want to be careful about how we're using, recycling, and conserving water. Most important aspect of purifying water would be for the humanitarian side. Being able to provide clean drinking water for people who have experienced natural disasters or infrastructure failure would save lives across the world. Primarily, what our team is focused on is the industrial processes in which we contaminate water. One example of this would be the cheese factories in southern New Mexico. In this process of creating cheese, phosphates and nitrates are introduced into the water, which render it unsuitable for use. With an increased number of drought conditions that we've seen in the Southwest, New Mexico is certainly a place that could benefit an increased water supply. So now that you know the motivation behind our project, you'll be excited to know that the scientists and engineers at the Petroleum Research and Recovery Center have developed a hollow nanofiber capable of desalinating water at a significantly lower cost than reverse osmosis. During the process of purification, dirty water enters through the interface of the nano-sized fibers, and clean water permeates out through the sides due to the porous design. The clean water will be transferred to a clean pond, and the dirty water will then exit the outer interfaces and be transferred to an evaporation pond with other heavy particulates. What our team has been tasked with this semester is improving the design of the multi-bundle module. We were able to reduce our footprint and store more fiber bundles into a larger 10-inch module, and our team has designed a shrouded plate and perforated pipe to protect the integrity of the fibers. Also this semester, we set up a 3D printer and calibrated the machine to optimize concept printing that would allow our sponsor to be able to take to an injection molding company to start mass production. As briefly mentioned before, we're focused on the project for the cheese factory in Clovis, New Mexico. This project is closely approaching, and this semester, our team helped with the design and construction of the trailer module that will be used for removing the phosphates and nitrates at the processing plant. We also provided CAD modules, documentation, and for the development. We look forward to seeing what the future will hold in this new developed technology, and we're eager to see these fibers help in producing fresh water throughout the world.